मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडे सेशन वी स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर नंबर 10 व्हिच इज द ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री पार्ट दैट इज हैलोहैलिडेन एंड हैलोहैलिड्स। आई होप योर फिजिकल पार्ट विल बी वेरी क्लियर एंड टुडे सेशन वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री एंड इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट लेसन फॉर आवर बोर्ड पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द कंसेप्ट्स आर लर्न इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर। In our first session of the halohalides and halohalides, what we have learned, we just learned here what are the actually halohalides and halohalides, how can we classify them, and how can we give the IUPAC nomenclature of these halohalides and halohalides on level. So first, as it is named halohalides, and we know that what are halides, when carbon-carbon chain are bonded together with a single carbon. Single carbon chain or single bond appear in between the carbon-carbon, then we will consider as a alkane. It means that sp3 hybridized carbons are there and they are joined together. We simply consider as a halo. Now, what do you mean by haloalkane? When halogen groups are present in the alkane, then we will consider as a haloalkane. Just for example, we know that CH4 is a methane. It is a methane. But one of the carbon is replaced by the any halogen group. What are the halogen group? We know that chlorine, bromine, iodine, these are the halogen group. So one of the hydrogen group is replaced by the any halogen group, then it will be converted into the haloalkane. Just for example, methane, when I write methane and one hydrogen is removed, then it will be cut. And one chlorine group is added instead of hydrogen, it will be converted into the CH3Cl. And I call this chloromethane. So when I think it is clear now what is haloalkane, when any halogen group, chlorine, bromine, iodine, bromine is attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon. And sp3 hybridized carbon means simply these carbon are attached with the single bonds. So single bonded carbon is there, and the chain which have a single bond carbon and they have a halogen group. It also are known as haloalkane. Just for example, you see in this particular case, here CH3CH double bond CH2 and Cl. You see here this double bond is also in the chain. But the halogen group is attached, that carbon is sp3 hybridized. That's why we include this example into the haloalkanes. Now second, our word is haloalkanes. What are halogenes? When the halogen groups are attached in the attached to the aryl group of the carbon. Aryl groups are the carbon, generally we consider simple that when they are attached to the benzene ring or derivatives of benzene ring, then we will consider as a haloalkane. Just for example, if we consider we have this, we know that this is our benzene ring, and if we put chlorine here, it is known as chlorobenzene. And secondly, if we want another derivative, just for example, you put like this CH2Cl. It is also included into the haloalkanes. Okay, so there are two basic kinds, haloalkane and haloalkane, and one by one we have learned their nomenclature and classification, and then we should learn about their properties, physical and chemical properties, which type of the reaction they are given in the particular session. Now, next is classification and nomenclature. First, classification of the haloalkane. First we discuss about the haloalkane, and the first classification basis number of halogen atoms. How much number of atoms are present in the alkane chain? It is 1, 2, 3, what are the present? If only a single halogen group is present in the carbon chain, then we will consider as a monohalide. If there are two halogen groups are present in the carbon chain, then we will consider as a dihalide. It may be like this, it may be like this also. For example, two halogen groups are attached to the single carbon, so then we will also consider it a dihalide. Third category is trihalide, when the three carbon atoms or three halogen atoms are attached to the carbon chain. It means when a single halogen group is present, it is considered as a monohalide. Two halogen groups are present, dihalides, and three halogen groups are present, then we will consider as a trihalides. Now, these monohalides are further classified. Dihalides are further classified. First, we have learned about the monohalides. How much types of monohalides are benzylic halides. What are alkyl halides, allylic halides, and benzylic halides? Now, what is alkyl halides? What is alkyl halide? As name indicates, halides which are attached to the alkyl carbon. Alkyl carbon, simple haloalkane. Just for example, halide is pure chloromethyl. So it is one of the type of alkyl halide, and we will consider that when halogen groups are directly attached to the those carbon which are sp3 hybridized. What is that? In monohalide, the first category is that in which a single halide is attached to the that carbon which are sp3 hybridized. Means if this carbon is sp3 hybridized carbon, in that particular case we will divide into the three types. It is alkyl halide, allylic halide, and benzyl halide. In both the cases, the halogen groups are attached to the dead carbon. If that carbon has the sp3 hybridization only. Just for example, in alkyl halide, we will consider what is alkyl halide? C2H5X. It is chloroethane. So chloroethane, chloromethane, chloropropane, or bromopropane, bromoalkane. These all are alkyl halides. These alkyl halides are further divided into the different types, that is primary alkyl halides, secondary alkyl halides, and tertiary alkyl halides. Now, what alkyl halides? Primary, secondary, and tertiary. What is primary alkyl halide, and what is secondary alkyl halide, and what is tertiary alkyl halide? It is very simple. Alkyl halide, a halogen group is attached to the dead carbon, which is sp3. These are further divided into the primary, secondary, and tertiary. Okay, so what are the primary ones? Simple. Just for example, this halogen group is attached to this carbon is sp3 hybridized. And this sp3 hybridized carbon is attached to the single carbon. It attached to the single carbon, then will be considered as a primary one. But if this sp3 hybridized carbon attached to the two carbon, directly two carbon are attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon, and if this hydrogen carbon is attached halogen, then it is considered as a secondary halide. And when three carbons are attached with the carbon to which halogen group is attached, then it is considered as a tertiary alkyl halide. So it means alkyl halide further divided into the primary, secondary, tertiary one on the basis of that. The particular carbon to which halogen group is attached, what is the degree of that carbon? It is a primary carbon, it is a secondary carbon, and it is a tertiary carbon. Primary carbon are those carbons to which only a single carbon chain is there. Secondary carbon, those carbon to which a two carbon chain or two carbons are directly attached. And the tertiary carbon are the carbon which have three carbon chains are directly attached. So basically, alkyl halides are divided on the basis of that. Now, what about the allylic halides? In allylic halides, a particular sp3 hybridized carbon, just for example, in this particular example, we can see here is a double bond, and this carbon is sp3 hybridized. And it is attached to the sp2 hybridized carbon, just for example, in this also. I put here in this in haloalkane. Why? It is an allylic halide. So, what is allylic halide? A particular halogen group is attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon, but this sp3 hybridized carbon is directly attached to the double bonded carbon or sp2 hybridized carbon. It means when a particular carbon is attached to the double bonded carbon, it is known as allylic carbon. It is known as allylic carbon, and this from this allylic carbon, if halogen group is attached, from this halogen group attached, then it will consider as a allylic halide. Now, what is benzylic halide? A benzylic halide, when the benzene ring is there, and on the benzene ring there is an alkane chain. It means on from this benzene ring there is an alkane chain, and to which a halogen group is attached, then it will consider as a benzylic halide. In this session, we will learn about this. And what about the nomenclature? As we know that in IUPAC nomenclature, we first give the suffix, then the main group, main name, which will denote the number of carbons of the chain, and then the prefix. So generally, the normal pH of the haloalkanes are used, and their surfaces are used for the near normal pH. It means the chloro-bromine groups which we added in the carbon chain, they are present, their name is present as a suffix before the main carbon chain name. For chloride, chloride group we use fluoro. For bromide group we use bromo. For iodo group we use iodo. For fluorine group we use fluoro as a suffix. Just for example, I said this is the chloromethane because it is a derivative of methane. So there is a name of the element is methane, and the hydrogen is replaced by the chlorine. Then we put the suffix fluoro in the before the name and name as the chloromethane. In the next class, we will discuss this all the one by one. What are the benzylic halides and the different category of dihalides and polyhalides? Thank you.